Beyond the horizon of these warm waters lapping the shore of Zar Zis, tragedy is playing out. And time and tide are bringing the bodies of its victims to these tourist beaches. More than 70 migrants drowned last month when their inflatable raft sank in rough weather. The director of the Red Crescent who helped pull them out of the water told me the corpses were floating in from every direction.
Saving these people and even returning them to a prison in Libya is better than letting them die like that in huge numbers. Young people, pregnant women and babies, it's the northern European countries that bear a heavy responsibility. It's a crime.
This garbage tip outside Zar Zis is where the dead bodies used to be dumped. The Red Crescent has now reburied them nearby. But these graves share the same ground as the city's rubbish. We spoke to a young man who nearly ended up here himself.
We left Libya in small boats into the deep sea. The boat started to shake until it capsized. In that moment, I regret what I did. And now, every time I remember what happened, I feel sick.
Mohammed is taking refuge at the Red Crescent Center outside Zar Zis. Other survivors like him are still struggling to cope with the terror they endured, wondering if they ever dare to go through it all again to reach Europe. A new cemetery is being built here. It already contains the bodies of 71 people that were washed ashore on the city beaches last month. Each of these graves have been numbered and a DNA sample has been taken from each one of the victims. The record of those is being held at the local hospital. Already, the director of the Red Crescent is receiving inquiries from all over the Sahel region and even from Morocco about who might be lying here. These waters are meant to be a source of fun and pleasure, but the death toll is rising all the time, and that's the reality that's haunting this beach. David Chater, Al Jazeera, Zar Zis.